Here we go. Y'all wanted gameplay, and it's about to grace your screen in just a moment. This is the new gameplay trailer for Doug Flutie's Maximum Football. I actually saw this a little bit earlier in the week because I'm a patron of theirs, and I was curious as to how the community was gonna react. This is an indie game with indie gameplay, but AAA features and depth as far as Dynasty mode goes. I wasn't sure if cats would understand that, but judging off the response, people seem to get it and cats are really excited. It's a major improvement from Maximum Football 18, so in just 1 year, they've come an extremely long way, and since switching their focus to college football, they've really picked up steam in the community, which is dope. In many respects, it's a major underdog story, and as I sit back and look at it, I'm realizing it's actually kind of similar to some of the content I do in my What Happened To series. And depending on overall interest, I might even go ahead and make that happen and kind of tell the story of this company and how they got to this point. Now, I do think the indie quality will steer some people away from the game, but this does, at least in part, scratch an itch for a lot of Dynasty connoisseurs, including myself. I love that they didn't try to be all things to all people here. They went for a very specific niche demographic within another specific niche demographic, and seeing the reaction, people who fall into this category are very happy. I'm looking forward to copping this when it drops next month, but with memories of NCAA 14 lingering in my head, I'm worried that the gameplay will limit the experience here, and for me, this might even turn into more of a Sim Dynasty type of game, which is honestly what I did in the older EA NCAA games. I basically spent all my time recruiting, setting up my depth chart, managing my team like that, and then I do like the off-season training, so that's definitely not a negative. I sunk tons of hours into playing the game like that. So if this does turn into that type of game for me, that's still a huge win, and I think they said the price tag was $30. It's definitely worth that, 100%. Overall, I'm impressed with what they've done, man. Like I say, major improvement from the last installment. Character models look a lot better. Dynasty dealt with recruiting and uni customization, 130 default teams. You got Ryan on the rosters. It's gonna be dope, man. And also, credit to these guys for bringing us content, consistent content each year, and improving with each installment. Now, like I say, the game drops next month. I believe the price tag is $30, so I'm definitely gonna support the game, and I'll be copping this on day one. Y'all let me know in the comment section, are y'all gonna be supporting? Are y'all gonna be copping this? You're gonna kind of sit back, see how things develop after the game comes out. Of course, whatever you decide to do is cool. But anyway, that's all I got for y'all today. Now, I dropped a video on yesterday talking about Tate Martell, some Last Chance U stuff, Dakota Allen. If y'all missed that one, it's going to be popping up on your screen right now. Be sure to go and check that out. My name is Flim Low Raps. I'ma holler at y'all next time, fellas. One. Yeah, you'll never know quitter, 'cause I'ma go, I'ma go, I'ma go get her.